If you're thinking about buying a 12th gen Intel CPU, then we need to have this chat because I'm seeing way too many comments and I can't save you all from making the same mistake. I've seen like, I don't know how many comments asking for the same thing. Oh, I went for this one. I went for this one. And I'm like, no, please, please, please don't make this mistake. Let's talk.
Licensing Windows has never been easier and cheaper. Go to whokeys.com, search for Windows 10 Pro license, or click on the link in the video description below. Purchase the license and use the code TN20 to get a 20% discount. Paste the key into the activation settings and you're all done. By the way, this license also works for Windows 11 when upgraded from licensed Windows 10. Check out whokeys.com in the video description below.
So, what is this mistake then? Basically, the Intel 12th gen CPUs over here have a few different variances of each model. So you can have i7 and there's lots of different ones of it. You have a K version, you have non-K version, KF version, and then there's other versions as well coming out. So how do you know which one should you choose as a creator? When one of the biggest differences or mistakes people can make with the 12th gen is choosing a KF variant of the CPU or just an F. If there is an F in the title of the CPU or in the CPU model of the Intel CPUs, it's not just 12th gen, it's the previous generations as well. What that means is there is no iGPU inside. And if you are a video creator or even photographer or just a creator, then that F for you should be meaning flipping stay away, because don't buy that one. I've seen so many comments where people have said, oh, I went with the KF version of this chip. And I'm like, why would you do that? Because just for example, go check out my 12600K and 12900K review, but the iGPU inside the GPU can give you up to 30 or 40% of performance compared to the KF version without the iGPU. The iGPU inside there is absolutely amazing. And if you're a video creator, and that just doesn't go with 12th gen, if you decide to go with 11th gen, because 11th gen still has a very good iGPU inside there, even though the CPU kind of lineup performance is very bleh. For video creators, the 11th gen makes quite a lot of sense compared to the 10th gen because it has extra video codec supported for encoding and decoding on the 11th gen compared to the 10th gen. But if you're a video creator and you go with any of the Intel CPUs, don't buy the F, KF, whatever F, if there's an F in the name, do not buy that because you're going to lose a lot of performance. And the price difference between the F and the non-F version or K version is only maybe like $50 at maximum or something like that. And that is not worth the price. Honestly, to pay $50, even if you don't need the iGPU, it's amazing to pay $50 for a graphics card that can support like two monitors, 4K monitors, just inside, built into your CPU. Why wouldn't you want that? Or if you want troubleshooting, or like I mentioned again, if you're a video creator, that's going to be amazing for you. So any of the variants of the 12th gen CPUs, stay away from the F variant. And you might be saying, I'm a gamer and I don't need it. Then gaming is one of the only kind of aspects where I'm saying, yeah, you probably don't need that iGPU because you're using, you know, your dedicated graphics to play all this stuff back. But if you're any other creator, it makes a lot of sense. For gamers, yeah, okay, I understand why you would go with a KF, like variant of the CPU. But even then, I'm thinking you might be able to use the encoders on the iGPU for your streaming, for example, and that will take the load off your dedicated graphics card, and the encoders can be on the CPU and things like that. So it still kind of makes sense to go with the K or, you know, non-F variant of the CPUs. Now, if you are a photographer, you might not even need a dedicated graphics card, because if you're using Photoshop or Lightroom, go check out my 12600K and 12900K review so you can see that. But if you're using those programs, then a dedicated graphics card will give you zero performance or next to zero performance. So there's no point of getting a graphics card to get a better performance in your Lightroom or Photoshop editing. What the graphics card will give you is like a monitor. You know, you can have lots of monitors if you're using like a lot of 4K monitors, but even those iGPUs can support like I think 2 or 3 4K monitors, which is a lot and very, very impressive. So if you want to be on a budget, instead of buying a dedicated graphics card, get the non-F variant of the CPU and just run those monitors. Make sure that your motherboard has, you know, like outputs or video outputs, because some of the motherboards only have one if you want to run one monitor. But if you need more than one, make sure that your motherboard has like 2 video outputs, like a HDMI or DP port. Also, when you're choosing the motherboard, make sure it is a display out, because that can be confusing. A lot of the motherboards these days have a display in port as well for the Thunderbolt connectors out to get a video out that way. So it's not like actual output of that. So you can't really run the monitor out of the DP port in. Just make sure that you know that when choosing a monitor. So photographers, this non-F variant makes a lot of sense. And to underline it one more time, for video creators, if you're a video editor, then one of the biggest mistakes you can do is go with the F variant of the CPU. And you might be thinking, but I still have my dedicated graphics card. Like, I can use that, right? Yes, the dedicated graphics card, like an NVIDIA cards, will have encoders and decoders inside the dedicated graphics card as well. But the 12th gen iGPU encoders and decoders inside there are much better than the NVIDIA graphics card drivers or encoders in there and the NVIDIA graphics cards. So basically, there's I think 2 media engines are inside there, and the 12th gen chips all have the same iGPU inside. Whether you go with i5, i7, i9, they all run basically the same. The encoders and decoders are the same. The GPU is basically the same on all of them. There's a little difference in the frequency they run and blah, blah, blah. But the actual media encoders and stuff, they are the same on all of them. And when you have your dedicated graphics card, those 2 GPUs, yeah, like your iGPU in your CPU and the dedicated graphics card, can work together. So if you're editing on Premiere Pro, for example, Premiere Pro will put the like video codec playback on the iGPU, because those encoders play very well back the H.265 and H.264 codecs, while your color grading and some of the GPU effects go on the dedicated graphics card that have a lot of like graphics power to actually, you know, work on all of those graphics. So yes, if you're wondering if the iGPU and your dedicated graphics card can work together, then yes, they can work together, and they do it very, very well. They use the encoders from the iGPU and then the rest of the graphics power from the dedicated graphics card, so it's definitely worth that. Please, if you're a creator, do not make that mistake by going with the F variant of the CPU. If you want to pick up any of those CPUs that I'm talking about, I'll leave these linked below. But before you buy this, go check out my reviews so you can decide really what works better for your situation or in your, you know, workflow. Feel free to go check them out. Okay, thanks guys for watching. I'll see you soon, and don't make that mistake. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I'll meet you down there. Thanks guys for watching. And before I say bye-bye, Windows 11 and softwares have been updating quite a lot. I've got another video coming up very, very soon where I'm gonna talk about the stability is getting better and better by a week on the 12th gen, and I'm super happy. Even the performance is better. My initial performance when I made the 12600K review, and now this latest benchmark that I'm running, there is a 7% difference. It's 7% better now, and that's amazing. Windows 11 was slower than the Windows 10, and now Windows 11 is faster than the Windows 10 by 7%, and that's a lot. Okay guys, anyway, just little tips. I wanted to talk to you. I didn't want you to make that mistake. See you soon. Bye-bye.